So when I was growing up in the D.C. area, about 19 years old, moved out to a big farmhouse with a bunch of people in Germantown area. We'd have rent parties, and I got to meet John Jackson and John Cephas and Cephas and Wiggins because they come out and play at these parties. And they got me into the style of Piedmont country blues, and loved it ever since, and I loved playing it. And I'm going to do a couple of songs from each of those fellas. The first one I do is called Bootlegger Blues, and I learned from John Jackson. It was originally done by Blind Lake, and it was called Bootleg Rum Dum Blues. And, it kind of goes along the line of, like, about every holler here, you've got someone making good whiskey, but every now and then someone doesn't know how to make it good and get sick on it. This is about the latter. Called Bootlegger Blues. Thank you. song by John Seaton, it's called Black Cow on the Line. And learned from him when I was visiting him at his house in Bowling Green, Virginia. He unfortunately passed away in 2009. His partner, Bill Wiggins, is still out there active playing, and it's worth seeing.
Thank you.
Piedmont Blues epicenter with the Durham at that time. And Blind Boy Fuller passed away in 41, and Bradley learned all a lot of the songs, so he took over, and Monkey Records didn't want to stop a good thing they were making good money on. So they named Brown McGee Blind Boy Fuller number two, and put out records like that. And eventually he got his own name back, but kind of set in there, you know, just all part of passing along the tradition.
Thank you.
heads.
Both of them.
Both of them. Well, this song wasn't a hit. It's coming up with what mine, but the guy that did it, his name was Jim Jackson. It was called Move to Kansas City, and it was a really long song. It was so long, it took four sides of the 78 to be able to fit it all. So it's Kansas City, Move to Kansas City, Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, and Part 4. If you play the whole song, I mean, it's probably like, I don't know,
20, 25 minutes. Because they couldn't get all the verses in.
But this is one of the, you know, real famous ones, and one of the first recorded songs to sell a million copies.
Our version hasn't sold that.
Man!